Dear students, Sat Shri Akal. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we are come up with the revision of class 6, Computer Science, lesson 5 and lesson 6. You know that the Punjab School Education Board is going to conduct the November-December monthly examination. We have prepared this video keeping this exam in mind. Before proceeding with this video, I request you that if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe to this channel and don't forget to click on the bell icon so that you will be notified of all my upcoming videos. So let's start the video. So first of all, we take a look at the paper pattern of class 6 subject computer science. A paper of total 12 marks will appear from class 6 lesson number 5. MS Paint Part 2, which will have 6 questions of 1 marks, 3 questions of 3 marks and 1 choice question, and no question of 5 marks will come from this lesson. Similarly, a paper of total 13 marks will come from lesson 6, Hardware and Software, in which 5 questions of 1 mark, 1 question of 3 marks and 2 questions of 5 marks will come from this lesson, out of which 1 question will be asked. By keeping this paper pattern, student can score well in the exam. Now let us start the revision of lesson 5 and lesson 6 through this video. We will now learn about fill in the blank in lesson number 5. So our first fill in the blank is, the clipboard menu has 3 options: cut, copy and dash, and the option are paste, move, close, zoom. So the right answer is the clipboard menu has 3 options: cut, copy and paste. So our second fill in the blanks is, the top button, a diamond shape with a line through it, is dash, and the option are paste, cut, copy and crop. The right answer is the top button, a diamond shape with a line through it, is called crop. So our next fill in the blank is, the dash tool can be used to draw pentagon, and the option are triangle, rectangle, pentagon or hexagon. So the right answer is the pentagon tool can be used to draw pentagon. So our next fill in the blank is, the eraser tool erases the part of a picture with the dash button of the mouse. So the option are left, right, scroll or none of the above. So the right answer is the eraser tool erases the part of a picture with the left button of the mouse. So our fifth fill in the blank is, color 2 is used if we press with the dash button of the mouse press. So the option are left, right, scroll or none of the above. So the right answer is color 2 option is used if we press with the right button of the mouse press. So now we will learn about very short answer type questions. So our first question is, which tool is used to draw a square? So the right answer is a rectangle. So our next question is, which tool can be used to erase a part of the picture? So the right answer is crop. The third question is, which tool allow us for zoom in and zoom out picture? So the right answer is zoom. Our fourth question is, which tool is used to freehand drawing? So the right answer is pencil tool is used to freehand drawing. So our next question is, what tool can we use to write text in our drawing? So the right answer is, text tool can be used to write text in our drawing. So now we will learn about short answer type question, and the first question is, what are the options available in the clipboard menu? So various options in the clipboard menu. First one is cut, second one is copy, and third one is paste. So next question is, write about crop option. So the button at the top of the home tab, image group with line in the middle of the diamond shape, is called the crop button. It helps us to crop our picture to the selected area only. So our next question is, write the name of the tool available in the tool menu. So the name of the tool available in the tool menu as shown in the picture. So first one is pencil, second one is fill with color, third one is text, fourth one is eraser, fifth one is color picker, and sixth one is magnifier. So now we will move to fourth question. So our first question is, what is size tool? So size tool is a tool which can be used to increase or decrease the thickness of the border of your brush or a shape. So this tool is active when we choose a brush or a shape tool. So next question is, write about brush. So using the brush tool, we can create drawing using different texture and shapes of brushes. So we can control the size of the brush with the size tool or the brush tool. So our sixth question is, give the name of group present there in Hometown Ribbon. So the name of the group present there in Hometown Ribbon are, first one is clipboard, second one is image, third one is tools, fourth one is brushes, fifth one is shapes, sixth one is size, and seventh one is color. So now we will move to long and short questions. So first question is, explain the color tool of MS Paint. The color section of the ribbon has three parts, boxes showing the active color, that is color 1 and color 2, the other color palette, and the edit color button. So the our first point is color 1 and color 2. So color 1 is the foreground color and is always black when we open Paint, and color 2 is the background color and it is always white when we open Paint. So the second part is color palette. So there are different colors available in the color palette for making a picture. And the third part is edit color. The edit color button always allow us to add color other than the color palette. So second question is, what is a text tool? How is the text formatted? So text tool is used to fill text in images or drawing sheet. So steps to format text are, first one is, select the text tool from the tools menu and type the text by dragging the mouse over the sheet. And the second point is, select the text and choose the font from the text toolbar with the help of mouse button by up and down in the font list. As we do this, the appearance of the text we have typed will change accordingly. Similarly, you can format the text by changing the font style, font size, and color 1 and color 2 option.
So we will now learn about fill in the blank in lesson number 6. So our first fill in the blank is, computer is a combination of hardware and dash, and their option are software, application, processor, or all of these. And the right answer is, computer is a combination of hardware and software. So second fill in the blank is, set of instruction is called dash, and your option are software, hardware, program, application, and the right answer is set of instruction is called program. Third one is, group of program is called dash, and your option are hardware, software, processor, or none of these, and the right answer is group of program is called software. So fourth one is, software is of dash types, and your option are 2, 3, 4, or 5, and the right answer is software is of two types. Fifth one is, computer cannot work without dash, and the option are Word, Excel, operating system, PowerPoint, and the right answer is computer cannot work without operating system. So now we will learn about very short answer type question. So first question is, which part of CPU connect the other part like processor, hard disk, RAM, etc.? So the right answer is, motherboard part of CPU connect the other part like processor, hard disk, RAM, etc. The second question is, what we call a set of instruction given to a computer? So the right answer is program. Third one is, which part of computer cannot be touched but felt? And the right answer is software. Fourth one is, what are the two types of software? So its right answer is system software and application software. Fifth one is, which type of software are expensive? So the right answer is system software are very expensive. Now we will learn about short answer type question. So first question is, what is hardware? The physical part of a computer that we can see and touch are called hardware. Example of hardware are keyboard, mouse, monitor, printer, motherboard, speaker, etc. data is also stored and processed in hardware. So our second question is, what is software? A set of programs is called software. We can do any work in the computer using these software. These are the part of the computer that we cannot touch. For example, paint, notepad, windows, etc. Software is used to control hardware devices and perform specific tasks for the user. And third one is, write the name of the devices which are connected with motherboard. The main devices which are connected with the motherboard are as follow. The first one is processor, second one processor fan, third one RAM, fourth one hard disk, fifth one power supply, and the sixth one is CD or DVD. The fourth question is, give four examples of hardware. Example of hardware are, first one is keyboard, second one mouse, third one monitor, fourth one speaker, fifth one system unit, and sixth one is printer, etc. So fifth question is, what are the qualities or features of software? The quality of the software are as follow. The software has no weight, we cannot touch them. The software commands the hardware to work. Software is valuable. So our sixth question is, explain the important points for taking care of hardware. So here are some key points to keep in mind about hardware. We must keep the computer part clean. The computer should be covered after use. The wire of computer part should not be pulled. Part of the computer should be properly maintained and protected from breakage. You should not turn on the computer and clean it. A clean or soft cloth should be used to clean computer hardware. Don't eat or drink anything near the computer. The computer keyboard button should not be pressed too hard. So now we will learn about long answer type question. So first question is, write the difference between application software and system software. The difference between application software and system software are, system software are essential part, whereas application software are non-essential part. And the second one is, system software are very complex, whereas application software are very simple. Third one is, system software are very expensive, whereas application software are cheaper software. Fourth one is, system software are made by experts only, whereas a person with less experience can make application software. Fifth one is, the computer cannot function without system software, whereas in the application software, the computer can work without it. So the example of system software are operating system, whereas Paint, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, games, etc. are the example of application software. So the second question is, write a note on hardware. The physical part of a computer that we can see and touch are called hardware. Example of hardware are keyboard, mouse, monitor, printer, motherboard, speaker. Data is also stored and processed in hardware. So key feature of hardware are, we can touch the hardware, we can feel the hardware, hardware takes up space, data is stored and processed in hardware.
So student, I hope you have reviewed lesson 5 and lesson 6 through this video well. I hope you will get good marks in the papers. Thank you.